Hello, this is Captain Poodle speaking. Are you ready to find love?
Yes, ahoy, matey.
Love. Exciting and new. Go online. They're catfishing you.
Shocker.
Fiance.
Soon you'll be flying to parts unknown.
90-day Beyonce.
Marrying someone you only met on your phone.
Be they French or Chinese, a brand new K-1 visa's the key.
Ooh, the key to what, Poodle?
To love.
It's reality, yes, let's love.
This is like a hometown show for us.
It is. I have a lot of family, and he has a lot of fuck buds.
Speaking of, all I can do is stare at this man with a shirt that says, "Call me Daddy."
Yeah.
Sir, thank you. We'll talk in the alley.
That one says, I love gay beer, and I do love beer.
Can beer be gay?
Yes. Yes. Oh, we got people here, too.
Every beer is gay during Pride Month.
That's true.
They're all like, remember, we love gay people. Here's a rainbow.
Because they know gay people spend the most drinking.
Because gay people drink. Because we want to forget.
Now, we appreciate that a lot of y'all here tonight because... God bless. Y'all been having some weather, and I'm sorry about
that. It's been crazy. And you know what? I'm glad. Thank you guys for...
It is Poodle's fault. It is. We had a drive-through.
Why do I get blamed for this?
You're the one that brings all... We had an earthquake in New York, and it was your fault.
We did. We drove through some horrible storms on the way here from Austin on I-34. I mean, I-35. It made me feel like I was 34. even though I'm not there. And why does that number feel good to me? I don't know.
Let's move on. I don't know.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it. Poodle was driving, and for me, I was like, boy, I haven't seen a thunderstorm in a long time. Just kind of like watching the lightning crash.
As I was driving through sheets of torrential rain, and then, pounding upon my... Y'all were driving an expedition. Have you ever seen two gays drive an expedition?
Yeah, it's just...
No gays have ever sat in this car.
No.
The car doesn't understand it.
No.
I actually was trying to park in Austin. You know those clearance things you kind of laugh at? You're like, no car's ever tall enough for that. I scraped the fuck out of that thing.
We had a sissy. She messaged me before the show yesterday.
This was weird.
And she said, hey, I want to give you some gummies. I make homemade gummies. And this is Austin, y'all. And I'm like, my mother's here. So I said no, but Jake would like some. So I got some for Poodle.
Yeah, for me.
For me. I didn't know it. We didn't see her. And I was like, oh, I guess she didn't come or whatever. We go to get the expedition. Jake drives from the parking garage. We load in the stuff. And then we're driving like only like a mile to the hotel. And Jake said, why is there someone's salad?
It looked like a salad.
Sitting on the trunk of the car.
Sitting on our car.
And we get there.
It was gummies. She had found the expedition.
Because we had mentioned that we scratched the card. And I was like, are we being stalked? Like, we thought someone's going to wear our skin.
Bitch found the one expedition.
She said, I found an expedition with a scratch roof. She said, and I just said a gay prayer and hoped it would happen. So there we go.
God was like, let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be. Now, this is, as y'all know, this is a great show tonight. First of all, we're going to be talking about a happily ever after, but all I wanted to mention, we've got My mom is here tonight, Mama Mar.
Yay!
My brother and my sister-in-law, Brad and Amber, are here.
You have cousins here?
All of my, I have my very best friend from 5 years old, who's my brother, Sean, is here. My other friend, remember when I went to Italy and I sent all those pictures with me and a girl? And it's my friend Lori's here, my best friend from 13.
Oh, Lori's here.
We've got the guy who did the estate sale after my dad dies here. I've got all Chaparral Acres here tonight. But I even got my sister cousin Kelly here tonight. And y'all.
Sister cousin.
Aunt Peggy is here tonight.
With her lip.
She brought the lip. So y'all are in for it.
She'll be signing autographs here. It's $100. Yeah.
I don't think she realized. I posted it to the Facebook group, and I think a couple of y'all fucking flew here to meet her. I don't know your lives.
You won't be disappointed.
You won't be. She's worth it. She's worth it.
Anyway, we could not be happier to be here in Dallas, and this is really fun. This is where we kind of met, kind of.
We knew each other.
We both went to UNT in Denton.
I have a friend from UNT tonight too. So yeah.
I didn't go to a single sports game, and I didn't know that was a thing.
Yeah, really? Well, you were a grad student.
I was a grad student, so I was like, yeah, I'm teaching classes and being paid to go to school.
I think we learned it when in undergrad we went to a football game once, and then realized at the time they fucking sucked.
It's like,
and it was boring.
I went to University of Michigan, which is literally like one of the biggest football schools in the country, and I went to one game. But I did learn to go, go blue! And people will go, go blue! And I'll go, and I'll feel like I matter.
I get it. Yeah. I get it. It's our sports inferiority.
All the music people were just like, we're like, football.
We don't care about that.
I need to practice. I need to practice piano.
We also, we can announce this. We did talk about this like 2 days ago, but we didn't talk about it tonight.
I don't know what you were talking about.
Y'all, big news.
Is it?
We're back on TikTok.
Oh!
Yes. We are.
Now, it's not because they reinstated us. We're just going to make up a whole fucking new account.
So, Caitlin, God bless her, reality gaze.
It's all homophobia.
It is. I am buying a burner phone just for TikTok. I'm now that bitch. I'm not putting it on my phone.
But I'm going to fuck the president of TikTok just because.
Yep. Well, you were in China. Maybe you're the reason we got banned and we just don't know it.
Fair.
So, Reality Gaze Pod, you can follow us on TikTok. Also, did y'all see the trailer for Toe?
Okay, y'all, we're going to be treated to a lot of good shit. Besides
Shekinah and Sarbar.
Yes.
With her him designing her new nose.
That's rough.
Like, take a moment. Take a moment and let that flow through you.
You did want to do that before I had plastic surgery. I actually wanted
to show where all your flaws were and how they could make them better because they're just so appalling to
me. That's true.
It'd be easier to look at you, but
I get it.
That's fine.
I get it.
And you came out with this, which is still not great.
Bitch, but, I'm snatched.
You know,
I'm snatched.
It is what it is. And there's also, I think, there's also Statler and Dempsey, which is just still feels like two gay Muppets.
Really? Truly.
But there's a dark Irish guy who's like tatted up and with a woman who's like from New York. And his mother's like, you're not going to go there. You're going to leave us all. We're from New York.
There's a black woman in America who's, is he in Iceland or?
A black woman who's moving to Iceland.
Iceland. And you see her mother look at her going, how many black people are in Iceland? And she says, probably like five. And her sister is there and goes, ha!
Y'all, five is a way overestimation.
Yeah, I don't think there's a lot. It's gonna be great, and it's gonna be a mess.
It is my favorite iteration of Night at Beyonce. I know yours is Love in Paradise, right?
Now mine is The Single Life. Love The Single Life. Oh
no, that's the most cringy.
I also enjoyed Last Resort.
You're wrong.
I got some cheers on that. Who's some last resort bitches in here?
This is...
Yeah. Oh, suck it, Poots.
This is from the same person who likes MILF Manor. So.
Yes. And tonight you're going to get a MILF Manor minute.
Should we just do the podcast?
Let's do the
podcast.
Listen
to the podcast. Ooh. Ooh.
Y'all know this one. It's a banger.
They're back in 9 Day UK, y'all. Listen. Listen.
I love you, chicken.
Now, try not to move.
Working on my twerk. It's getting better.
Hey.
Yeah. A little locked up tonight.
This man over here. Cut it, Gary. Cut this shit.
Cut this shit.
This man over here just whispered to his wife saying, this is real gay.
This is real, yeah.
I didn't expect, you told me about it, but I didn't expect this.
It can always get gayer, sir.
And how you can do that is meet me in the alley.
There you go.
Right after.
Again, not me for Poodle.
Honey,
Mom?
I'll bring him back to you, but he'll be changed.
He'll be changed.
You might recognize him. We'll see.
Okay, I got to get my... I got my...
Whoa.
I got to get situated.
Yo, look at this set. How cute is this?
It is beautiful. We love this.
Don't you love the factory? Studio at the factory?
I think this is our third time to be here.
Second.
Oh, second. The last time we were here,
listen to this bitch. Just correcting us.
Sadly, my nephews aren't here tonight. They have real lives now. But last time they were here.
Boo.
One of them got so drunk he hit on Sissies. And I think some of them were married.
It was
so
pretty remarkable.
So it's probably for the best. Kids got pulled.
And wasn't he like 25 at the time?
He was 21. 21. Y'all, don't fuck with Lamar.
No, really, don't fuck with Lamar.
Don't fuck with Lamar.
Like, seriously, you don't know what you'll pull, you don't know what to bring back.
Woo!
Let's just jump in, y'all. American Meemo!
Y'all, so tonight... We're talking about Angela and Michael.
Angela and Michael. At this point, isn't it just a watch where we just kind of go, who is the audience anymore for it? I think this is definitely their last season, by the way. We've heard it just because here's how we know. You know when someone is on social media bashing the network, which is what's been happening, they're never coming back.
That's how you'll know when Poodle gets canceled.
Because I'm like, let's say out. What reality game is this? Is the best comedy who doesn't know what to do it?
Yeah, so.
So American Meemaw, y'all, she's the kind of person who needs to show that she's from America wherever she is. Because I guess
she looks like an actual Muppet with her hair up so high. Or not a Muppet. Well, I guess but more like a Fraggle.
Yeah.
Right?
I thought a
cigarette.
I just realized before we get too much into this, I just want to have like a really honest moment with you I've noticed that, just to be honest, you had a rough time with, you had a breakup, and you had things. And recently...
And Dad, fake cancer, as you say.
I wasn't going to mention the breakdown.
He never believed it. He thought I was just trying to get away from him.
But I was going to say, you've been recently trying to get back out there.
Yeah, I've been throwing that ass in a circle.
And I want to validate you and say that I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
And I also want to show you that I have a hidden camera clip of you actually approaching someone. Gary, can you play that first clip we've got there?
Oh, Jesus.
Roll it.
Hello.
Bonjour, madame. Comment vous allez?
Bonjour, English.
See, you're trying. I appreciate that.
Okay, you don't speak French.
Oh, you speak English?
Yes.
Oh, thank God. I just need a beer. I'm having a bad day already.
Okay.
So I don't want to have to... anyway, I'm nervous, see? We got an Argus, my husband, actually.
And see, your game could be better.
Okay. And we got in a big argument. I didn't go with him. And now I feel bad, and now I'm just nervous. And
that's the biggest situation.
It is. I'm sorry to vent to you. If he don't show up, you want to go to dinner? I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
That's
I'm
his
trying
move,
to lighten
y'all.
Things up. I'm just kidding. I'm sorry to take your time. So. Just a beer and a glass, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
That's his move. So
I do flirt with the writers and say, I'm just kidding.
I'm you not. Tried.
And I tell them too much about my life, and they're just staring at me going, just give me fucking 20%, you marry.
I've seen it. It's really embarrassing. You just
it
grit
is.
Your teeth through it.
That's fair. That's fair.
Anyway.
All right, moving on.
So let's move on.
But wait a minute.
Uh-oh.
Funny, because I couldn't use a secret camera. I've actually been having a very small man following you, I can't say the word.
That's who that was. Surreptitiously.
Surreptitiously, thank you. Can't say with my adult braces. It's too hard. I think I got some dinner in them, by the way.
Surreptitiously. Yeah.
So, but someone's been following you, and actually,
oh, no.
I have a clip of you leaving a gay sex ball after getting banged by 10 men. Can we can we roll that clip, please? Lighting, Gary, roll clip 2.
Yeah, Loren.
Well, let me pull this in first. Okay, my G.
Hello.
Hey. We made
Hello.
It.
Hello. I'm afraid to touch you.
Okay.
That's true.
See,
I'm always afraid to touch you when you get back from one of those. Tell me it's not real.
I think I look great there.
Yeah.
I got a muumuu on. It's total Palm Springs chic. I'm killing it.
Killing it.
I think we're both doing well.
I think we're doing great.
Oh, that's foolishness.
Oh,
all
God.
Right, now that we've started off with that, oh, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus. So, there's not much of it. It's same. It really is the same story. Different
she tries to speak
moment,
her French. And as my favorite thing that Angela says is, ah, English.
I wasn't that bad. I tried in Italy. So did my friend.
I want to bring this up. Is her speech this season, I was like, has she been drinking? I think it's dental work.
I
think there's even more dental work than before.
Yeah.
And it's to the point that, like, you know she has to know something sounds off, but she doesn't care? Is that it?
I think I sound fine, and you tell me it's wrong all the time.
No, your speech is fucked.
Oh,
it's a problem.
Sounds good to me.
No, it's bad. So anyway, she's smoking, she's burping. Michael still hasn't called. Michael shows up, and you think it's going to be a fake out. He's like,
You do.
I didn't get the visa. And she's like, what?
Michael.
I can't believe this. I'm spiraling.
How many cigarettes, by the way, do we think she has smoked in that amount of time?
39. No, 34.
34. Yeah, that's a number. Got it.
My favorite number.
God, she smelled so bad. And she's freaking out.
She says, I knew there was going to be some screw up. It's going to be weeks and I need it. And then she's like, nobody goes what we go through.
I was like, yeah, millions of people do.
And I'm like,
you're a celebrity.
Well, lots of people have pain. And at one point, she says that the officer asks why he moved the case, and he's like, the backlog. And so there's a question if he move to the Ivory Coast and did not tell her, which is a great idea.
Yeah.
Just go, because I guarantee she thinks the whole country is Africa and Nigeria. There's just Nigeria and the rest of Africa.
She probably does.
And he could say Ivory Coast. She's like, is that in Nigeria? That's the white beach, isn't it?
Ivory Coast. I think we had a store called that when I used to work at the
Ivory Coast.
When I used to work at the Vista Ridge Mall in Louisville. I worked at the Gap Kids there, and I'm pretty sure there was a home.
It was
a knockoff.
It was like a craft store.
What was the store? The Bombay Sapphire. No, that's a gym.
The
Bombay Company.
Which was a horrible colonial organization.
But that was very popular, and I didn't know that then, and I loved to go in there and daydream about decorating because I never could afford anything there.
Like most of the straight boys your age.
But the Ivory Coast was the store, like, down the way. That was, like, the knockoff.
Sounds hot.
Yeah. It was probably even worse, but I would get some stuff from there every once in a while.
Anyway, Angela ends it with saying, I'm done, for which she has maybe said on camera for the 88,000th time, the 34,000th time.
Well, and apparently it comes to light that Michael says, Angela, and he says, it's only going to be one or two weeks, and she's like, we don't have 1 or 2 weeks, and I thought, by the look of you, Angela, you might not. You don't look well. And so
she has that look of her face that looks like it looks like she's been shellacked, like a cabinet.
Well, it's what happens when you have very kind of wrinkly skin and you try to get
crepey skin. She's got crepey skin.
Yeah, and you get a facelift with Botox, which you really can't get a facelift with Botox. So she's a little over Botox.
I see.
She needs a lift.
And the color of her skin's kind of like greenish yellow. It's off.
I'm telling you, she looks stressed. I mean, you can tell. But what Angela does in perfect Angela fashion, so we find out Michael is the one who moved. He moved the case.
He moved the case, but we don't know if he moved to Abidjan.
We don't know. But she immediately, he said he moved the case to expedite the process, but instead of like congratulating him, she immediately flies off the handle to, I can't trust you now, you're lying to me.
Why would he go through all this to lie to you again?
Why would he move and then tell you that he moved?
It's the anatomy of a con that he just wants to finish it and get to this country. Good Lord.
Yeah.
Why would he do this?
So they're doing toe.
P.S., y'all, he does make it here.
He does.
That has been.
Now,
no one deserves to be in America more than Michael.
No one. Now, have they actually ever been on 90 Day Fiancé?
No.
So, I mean, it probably won't because she's talk shit, but theoretically, he could come over and they could be on 90 Day Fiancé.
I don't think they'd air it.
But I think the fact that she, like, ended up beating up and having assault
shit
charges.
Y'all, you can't shit. You know what? The sad thing is, it doesn't matter what
if
you
she
do.
Assaulted,
you can do
care.
Anything you want. You can't shit talk the network.
Don't drag Matt Sharp.
Yeah. Actually, not even Matt Sharp. Network Legal says, nope, they shit talked us.
We don't know anything about that. We've never been sued by anyone.
Not at all.
No.
We're perfect little lambs.
Yes, we are.
That was weird.
It was a good lamb.
Loren and Alexi. Y'all, I've got to say.
I know you're grown, but look, half the cast are groaners. We got to do it.
I've got to say this about them. Alexi's a really good doting husband. She's getting home. She's still in a lot of pain. It's Rosh Hashanah. Her parents are over. And I went, this is a terrible idea.
It is.
You could have done your holiday dinner anytime.
It's only 3 days out,
like,
too.
I know Jewish families who do Rosh later because people coming in. It could have been any day. The day she comes home, come on.
It doesn't. We did Christmas last week, a week earlier, and guess what? It was more fun. Didn't have to deal with bullshit.
So
I loved it.
Y'all, if you've watched Loren and Alexi for any amount of time, you know that her mother, Marlene, is an absolute gargoyle.
Oh.
And no
one. She put
one,
the guilt in like, Jewish mother.
You would not wish Marlene on your worst enemy. And but if you also know from the very beginning, Loren has been a huge advocate. She came out basically and said, I have Tourette's syndrome. One of the first people, when people were still making fun of Tourette's, like it was just like cuss, 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 fuck, fuck, shit, like that. And so Loren was a big advocate for that. So you can actually see her ticking like a motherfucker.
Yeah, she's stressed.
In these scenes with her mom, and it's sad. So anyway, Marlene says, I'm afraid to touch you, like we just saw there.
Again,
and she says, how are you? I've been better. And she's like, but I have no chins. And Marlene, without missing a beat, I didn't notice them before, but it doesn't matter. Not helpful.
She's so horrible.
They're cleaning out the fridge. Lauren's like, Loren, because the whole family is based in this cycle of enabling and guilt, and Loren feels bad about not helping and helping with the kids.
And the mom never feels like validated, I guess. I loved when Alexi said, he got Loren settled, and he said, I'm going to go get the kids. And you see Marlene, she looked like her house just burned down. She went, ugh. I was like, your daughter had cert. Like, it's not the end of the world. Yeah.
There's a part where the kids come in, and y'all, far be it for me to talk about children's looks.
I don't like this.
They
I
all
do
look
not support
just
this.
Like Marlene. There's no Alexi in those kids. It's you're laughing, but you all know it's true.
They might grow into Alexi.
It's all Lauren's mother.
I do think Alexi should be shirtless more this season. Just my opinion.
It's been lacking in this season. So, y'all, it's Rosh dinner. We're having the holiday dinner. And Brian, her father,
her
says, how are you? And she's like, I'm hurting, really hurting. And both of them say, this mommy makeover is much more of recovery than we thought. It's a lot to do. And
Brian's like, well, maybe we shouldn't be here. And
I went,
but you're already here. So that's not helping any situation.
And she's like, it's a lot to do. And the mom went, well, you're not doing it. It's Alexi doing it. Have some more apples and honey.
Kind of what she said.
This is hard to watch, y'all.
And then, of course, Marlene then says it here in the moment, it kills me to go through this.
It's like I'm living
it. And I'm like, your daughter got a fucking tummy tuck. They just cut her the fuck open in the middle. She's walking around like the gay hunchback of Notre Dame. It's not about you, Mom.
She really should, like, convert to Christianity and, like, hang herself on the cross. It would just be the perfect martyrdom.
She should.
Just be the perfect martyrdom for her. She really is one of the worst mothers. And she does it like really low key, so you don't know it. It's not like Asuelu's mother who says, just give me money. I don't care about the kids.
She's up front.
Just give me
Tells
money.
You
it's
what
all
she
it's
wants.
What I want.
Not mad at that.
So anyway, she's like, it was my decision. Y'all, we've got another clip. This one's Loren and her mother. Roll the clip, Lighting Gary. Oh, yes, perfect.
Okay, Ashley.
Mm-hmm.
No?
So how you feeling?
I'm hurting.
Here we go. This is what I was talking about.
I'm really hurting. Like, my ears hurt from the bandage.
Lauren's
That's why
mother.
It's off right now. I'm not going to lie. It's more of a recovery than we thought. Right? Like, I've got the drains and
clock
this.
This.
And
maybe we shouldn't have celebrated tonight.
We're here, just and that's something to celebrate. Abba B is here. You guys are here. Yeah. We should be grateful we're here.
I know, but it's just a lot to do.
Well, you know, it's done.
Well,
we're
she's
here.
She's not doing it.
Tick, tick, tick,
yeah,
tick, tick.
Yeah, she immediately starts ticking. Bless her heart.
It's awful.
Thank
and we're
you
laughing
guys for
at
helping.
You know what? It was a pleasure.
Thank God Saba B's here.
Thank God.
It takes a village.
This is why young people have kids.
That's right.
This is why young people have kids.
You want me to. Thank God I have flexibility. It just kills me to see you going through this.
I wasn't expecting this recovery, but being excited about the results is what's getting me through.
But now you have to remember, you already have three children.
I know.
So why do it now?
Just grab your seat for the rest of it, y'all. It doesn't get better.
Oh, my God. It was my decision.
I know.
It was my decision.
Here we go.
What?
So no complaining allowed.
Boo.
No complaining allowed.
I'm going to go lay down.
Come.
Oh.
Now, just tell yourself, we all have problematic sometimes relatives, sometimes
not me,
relationships
not me
with
at
their
all.
Parents.
Mine are great.
But just know, if that shit is you, establish a boundary right now that it can't bother you anymore because it's not you. It's not you. It is that mother. That's not, and you just know that you're not the one disappointing your mother. She's been disappointed since she was born.
Because she probably, her mother probably made her
exactly.
feel disappointed.
Exactly, the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon.
You just, somebody sends you that energy and you say, no, thank you.
That clip when she's like, no complaining allowed. I had to pause and screech because I can just see something like that said at my dinner table. Go, Jaber, don't complain. You wanted the surgery.
That's what she would say. But also,
it is exactly what she would
say. It's catching because then later when she's in the bed, trying to get in the bed, and she's going, and Alexi said, well, you wanted to do this.
Yep.
And I'm like, so someone can have surgery and just letting a physical yelp of pain out is too much? Fuck
yeah,
you all.
They all kind of live in this gross place where they think it's okay to take pot shots at each other all the time. It's my house that I grew up
so
in.
So sorry, Loren is running everything and doing everything for it. And so sorry that for 3 weeks, y'all actually have to do some shit.
Right?
Anyway.
I'm getting my phone not because I'm on Grindr.
I don't believe you.
But because it's time for shout-outs!
Shout-outs, everybody!
Hit it, Gary. Well, there we go. What are you doing to your computer?
You know you make me wanna shout. Kick my heels up and shout. Throw my hands up and shout. Throw my head back and shout. Come on now. Don't forget to say you will. Don't forget to say yeah. Say you will. Say it right now, baby. Say you will. Come on, baby. Come on. Say you will. Say it better,
yeah. All right, cut this shit, Gary.
Y'all, my family is drunk. I just looked at their eyes. I'm like, oh, motherfucker.
I love it. All right, give us, oh my God. Give it. Someone arrest your sister-in-law. Did she just take her tit out?
You can't fuck with her. She's a nurse.
That's true.
Where are my nurses at, right? We love our nurses. Okay.
Ooh, let that music get a little louder, Gary. Just
Thank
a little
you.
Louder. Let
All
me
right.
get my hips moving.
All right, I'll go. The first shout out, Doug. Mistyping your name always results in D-Pig. You belong here. Love and stuff, Summer.
Oh, where's Summer and Doug?
Doug, you belong here. Well, he didn't show up.
No, fuck you.
All right, well, all right.
Shout out to my Irish husband, Gerlin. That is a new name for me. For coming with me tonight. When we get home, we're going to Raw Dog the American way. Jocelyn. There's a Jocelyn and Gerlin.
Because Jaren's going to Raw Dog Jocelyn so hard. She's going to cream it because she dreamed it. And then she's going to yell, America. Vulva.
Wow.
You want to read off mine?
No, I can see it. Y'all, the hotel fucked up our printing, so we're reading off phones. Happy birthday to Buggy from the Dark Lord and Mama Lou Who.
Oh, I love that one. Happy birthday.
That sounds like Chinese code, so we've just sold another company.
Yeah. Shout out, oh wow, shout out to my horse-cocked husband, Luis. Where's Luis? Where is Luis? Won't raise his hand. I can smell it. Smell it, poodle. Find it. Where are you? We're gonna get you, Louise. You can run. Thank you for being my reality TV buddy for life. Love your dick pig wife, Jordy. All right.
I predict the costume of choice tonight will be the Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders. Pom-poms and high-heeled boots and all, but probably I'm wrong. By the way, that was an okay reality show, the one about the cheerleaders. You could cover it by Curious Eliza.
I did watch that show. I did.
Thanks, Eliza.
Shout out to my husband, Steven, for attending another reality gay show with
me. Wow. Didn't you get it from the first time you came?
Yeah. Don't trip and fall into Poodle's playpen on your way out. Love your wife, Amanda.
Yeah, unfortunately, y'all, the area over here was supposed to be the Poodle's playpen. I tried to get rabid armadillos, but I could only get regular armadillos.
Oh, that's appropriate for Texas.
And it didn't really matter.
Though.
You know me. I have to have the best. So,
that's true.
Yeah. Thank
it's
you.
True.
Thank
All
you.
All right.
So I scrapped the playpen altogether.
You're next.
Thank you. That was said with such venom.
No, I was just saying it.
Shout out to Shelly and Amber. Amber, thanks for taking your Aunt Shelly to see the gays since I had to bow up because of my hemorrhoid surgery tomorrow.
Pray.
Pray for my asshole, y'all.
No. That's a rough. That's rough. Yeah. I remember my dad had to get
we've
that done.
All,
it's rough.
We've all said that prayer.
You have said that. I said that. Yeah.
Lord Jesus.
Yes. I remember dad's, Matthew, I'll tell you right now, they've shot that laser up my ass like goddamn Star Trek, and I came up off the motherfucking bed and almost hit the fucking doctor. But my hemorrhoid's gone, son. Literal, word for word. Okay, shout out to my neighbor's dog, Monty. He perks up.
Are we shouting out dogs now?
Yep. He perks up anytime he hears the intro to your show. Must be a low-key dick pig.
Definitely.
Love JT.
Okay, my favorite thing, this is a Carl's wife. It says, Kelly with an I.
That's him.
Kelly with an I. The next one is, thank you for introducing me to these amazing sissies. Happy late birthday, Kelly with a Y.
Kelly with a Y. I love that.
Yay!
Oklahoma ladies, I love it. Kelly with the I, Kelly. That sounds like, do y'all ever
Kelly with the I, not Kelly with a Y, because Kelly with a Y spells out death door.
Do you ever go, Kelly? Yes, Kelly. Do you remember Mama's Tune?
Mama's Tune.
I love that one.
Hi, is by Nobody.
Strim Sisters.
Mama's Tune.
To my amazing husband, thank you for bringing me to Dallas since I was worrying the boys would not end up coming to Denver. I love you.
Oh.
And you get a special combo tonight. P.S. Driving down the highway.
And you're going to get up the butt tonight. Shout out to all the Oklahoma sissies. Join our FB group. I assume that's Facebook.
Facebook, yeah.
And let's have fun in there, Sissy Christie.
Yeah.
Yay. Go for the Oklahoma sissies.
Yes. Shout out to my favorite down bitch, Abby Frizzell. Thanks for happily coming
Ooh,
to
Abby
see
Frizzell.
My... Thanks for coming to see my favorite gays with me, even though you have no idea what 90 Day Fiancé is. I love you so much, Claire.
I love these.
I love
this. To my dear friend Joan, this is her first time attending a Reality Gays live show. I'm sorry. She introduced me to two black girls, one rose, a friend of the pod.
Love
we love them.
Them
too. And I introduced her to Maddie and Poodle. Thanks for coming with me, Joan.
Just a few more. Hey, 1J.
1J.
Thank you for coming tonight. I love you. I didn't need to sign anything. They didn't sign.
Shout out to my sister, Sydney Shay. Sounds like a porn name. So glad I introduced you to the gays and that we can enjoy this moment. Thanks for always having my back.
Well, Sydney Shay, I love that. All right. Where am I? Okay.
Shout out to
El Amor de Mi Vida for coming to our second reality gay show. Can't wait to spend a kid-free night with you. Don't let Poodle hear your sexy Mexican accent. He might steal you.
The question is...
Fuck Poodle. Sugar, I'm going to steal your ass.
Will he steal me? That's the question.
Oh, I love a man who wears a collared shirt and then a vest because that means he has a job.
That's true.
That's what's attractive
that
to me
is
now.
Exactly
it means they have a job and a 401k.
That man has a job.
That's what it means. They built a career. Yeah. Yeah.
That man has spreadsheets.
Yes.
On his computer.
He does. He has a... Yes. He is on Teams every day. And I'm turned
Fuck
on.
Teams.
No more dusties.
To my BFF Steve, love you more than my luggage. Michelle in Pittsburgh, you're my true bliss always. Mwah, kissy lips.
This last one says, shout out to the Marr family tonight for making us feel like family through Matt's storytelling. All good, of
that
course.
That makes me cry.
Yes.
Not really.
All right, y'all. Go meet my family. Go get a picture with Aunt Peggy. Go get a picture with Kelly, everybody. We're going to go to intermission.
Go get a drink.
Get a drink. See you in a bit.
We'll see you in the second half.
Soft and kind when I was crying. Daddy's hands were hard as steel when I'd done wrong. Daddy's hands weren't always gentle, but I've come to understand.
Sing it, you sluts.
There was always love in Daddy's hands.
All right. Thank you, Gary. You can fade it out.
And I'm finally out of my way. I'm driving to the highway.
Yo, we were driving to the highway on I-34, I mean 35. But y'all, every time we drive down the highway, I think of this song. Enough of this shit, Gary.
Enough, Gary.
Oh, fuck me.
I got it. Sorry, my Virgo moon. I got to move these shot glasses for pictures. It looks trashy.
What about this show hasn't been trashy?
I know, that's true. Remember when we said it was going to be a short show?
And also remember when I said maybe the Grindr boys don't remember me? I was wrong. Jesus Christ. You show your face in a town every 2 years. Boy, it's like the face that launched 1,000 grinders.
All right, here you go.
All right, here we go. Y'all, let's talk about Patrick and Thais. Okay, let me just say this. First of all, this never needed to be on this season. The only reason it's worth anything is because of Boston John.
It's true.
I'm going to go to Brazil. I'm going to go to Brazil. Because I want to drink like a Brazilian. And it's going to be fun.
It's true.
I don't know if it's going to be fun.
Where are my notes? Where are my notes? Where are my notes? Okay.
So, y'all, remember, it's Thais's birthday. And Thais, who gives possibly some of the best face. Every time you'll see her, she's like, oh?
She does. She really does.
Oh? Oh?
She does do that.
It's wonderful, actually.
It's wonderful.
And so Thais is not really into celebrating her birthday. So what does Pat do besides go with his brother John? By the way, we all know that Patrick is possibly the most codependent person in the world. And he demonstrates it every time. And he's like, yeah, Thais didn't want to come out. And he's like, yeah, we're going to go out. It's going to be us.
It's going to be great.
It's going to be great. Fun.
It's okay if this beer is like half foam that you just poured me, but it's okay.
And he's like, and Patrick's like, you wish Thais a happy birthday? And he's like,
you know, I'm not going to text her. I'm going to say it in person because it's nicer.
Now, your John is starting to sound like an extra from Chicago, the musical.
Yeah, it kind of is. It's like, gee.
I enjoy it.
So anyway, John is just basically saying, so I didn't make a reservation. I'm just going to stay with you at the apartment. And Thais doesn't know anything about this.
And Patrick's like, okay, well, sure. Now, a normal husband, text your wife. Give her a call.
No, because he's too codependent with his brother right now because they've literally trauma bonded over just fucking growing up.
Oh, we're going to find out about that today.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, we are. Oh, man. So
every scene with them is riveting.
And Patrick said, yeah, I didn't tell her you were staying with us. And that's when John said, that's going to be marvelous.
That's going to be marvelous.
Marvelous.
So he talks about, Patrick says, so I had to go see Carlos and he wanted me to kiss the ring. He's like, nope. You don't kiss the ring. Our family doesn't kiss the ring. We don't kiss rings in this family. You already married her. You already married her.
It's true. It does feel like for him, it's like dick swinging contest now with the dad. And dad's going to win.
At one point, there's shots, and John goes, now Johnny's happy. As soon as they bring shots, Johnny's happy.
I am a little happier.
And, y'all, he drinks it like it's water, this shot that he gives it. He's like, pretty good. Pretty good.
He does just pop it.
And it's like, he talks about dad, his father, Jose, who was John's stepfather.
Yes.
Like, he's coming over and saying, he's like, oh, yeah, so you're doing some father-son bonding? And he's like, you know, you're his income. You're his bread and butter. That's why he's going to have you, like, paint the house and do all the shit.
So we find out that the dad is a user, and he even says, for the first time, I agree with Thais.
So for John to agree with Thais, Patrick's dad's a piece of shit, which we could all kind of tell.
Yes.
At this point, I want to roll the clip, Light and Gary, of Patrick and John, if it's there. Here we go.
Yeah, let's see if it's there.
I love it. We're like praying to the God.
I'm just looking out for you. He might be using you. I mean, he's not the best father. Let's be honest.
He's not the best father.
Neither is mine.
He wasn't.
Neither is mine. No, it's not, but I don't talk to my fuck.
Bro, your dad wasn't in your life at all.
He took me to some baseball games. Did he ever take you to baseball games? No. So shut up.
No, he didn't take me to baseball games, but like I lived with him. I mean, it was definitely harder on you than it was on me. You were a stepchild, bro. Like, I don't hold anything against anyone forever.
Well, you never held anything against him ever.
Yeah, because he's my family. He's my dad.
Well, yeah, well, you know, sometimes family sucks. Right?
Ooh. Who can relate? I love my family, but Jesus. Patrick needs to wake the fuck up. This guy's only using him for money.
Yeah.
Anyway,
he's not.
We've actually got a deleted scene that happened right after this.
We do?
So show this next clip.
I didn't know this.
Gary.
What is this?
Every day I come by your house and I pick you up. We go out, we have a few drinks and a few laughs, and it's great. You know what the best part of my day is? For about 10 seconds from when I pull up to the curb and when I get to your door. Because I think maybe I'll get up there and I'll knock on the door and you won't be
It's this happened right after.
No goodbye, exactly. No see you later, no nothing. Just left. I don't know much, but I know that.
Y'all, every single fucking time I watch their scenes, I think of this scene. Because he's like, the best part of my day is when you go away from me.
Did any straight men just start crying at that? Oh, God, I love it, babe.
This is so many straight men's favorite movie. It's this or the Shawshank Redemption.
Or,
who did I just nail? What straight man did I just nail?
I do love that movie. I do. Or...
It's your father's favorite movie Ghost.
My dad's favorite movie was Ghost, which my brother didn't believe me. But my brother's favorite movie, they even named their dog, is Rudy.
That's such a straight man movie.
I think it's because my brother was never really good at football.
Oh!
That's for the shot.
Okay, that is such a shot in the dark.
That's all right. He won state in speech. He's an amazing actor. Fuck football. Fuck those coaches that didn't want to let him go do theater. They tried to stop him.
So y'all,
Travis Scott.
I feel like we're digging up a lot of past
Oh, don't
drama.
Get me started about Travis Scott. My mother hates that son of a bitch. That was like, she went up there like she did with Bill George. I mean, she put on the power suit and showed him who was that.
A power suit?
Don't fuck with Lamar.
So anyway, we're back at the apartment, and Patrick's like, John's here, and he's like, happy birthday to you, and a half, like, happy birthday to you.
And then he says, I came here to sing you happy birthday. And I went, but you didn't sing her happy birthday. You didn't sing the whole fucking song.
I celebrated you with a birthday shot since you were drinking. It's fine.
Because, you got a baby. You're feeding a baby.
And Thais rolls her eyes and says, the baby's sleeping. Just shut the fuck up. And John's like, it's a nice place you got here. I might stay here for a while.
For a lot of you with mothers with young children, how real was this of your daily
just
ritual of getting people to shut the fuck up so
your
baby can sleep so you can just have an hour of your own time?
One of my best friends was like, don't ever fucking call me at 7 o'clock because I'm putting my baby down, and I swear to God, if you fucking ruin my baby going to bed, I will kill you.
That's fair.
And so I stopped calling. Anyway, so the baby's sleeping, and John's like, Patrick says, so John messed up his reservation. Mind if she stays here for a few nights? And she's like, you're a pain in my ass.
You're a pain in my ass.
And y'all, let's roll this clip of John. Y'all, this is every drunk person trying to be quiet.
All right, well, it's just for a couple nights.
Two nights, that's it.
He's not going to bother us.
Yeah, go to bed. Let me see what it's like. You know, I don't know.
All right, well, the room's here. Man. It's the first room on the right.
Hey.
Okay. Just be quiet.
That's a big bed?
Yeah, it's big enough. It's
a twin, at best.
Yeah.
Is that a big bed?
The baby's sleeping.
Why does he care if it's a twin?
I'm sorry.
I'm
being quiet. I'm just gonna go to sleep. No big deal, right? Theodore's happy to see me, right, buddy? Yeah, you should.
Every drunk person goes to the dog.
Yeah. See? He's happy.
The dog's not gonna judge you.
Okay, Emma, we'll be quiet.
Quiet.
Yeah, you two, like, just drink.
I'm not being loud.
Yes, like, two
it's whatever,
drinks,
I'm not being loud.
Come here, talk too loud, and guys, just.
This
fight is real.
I love my niece. I love my niece. You know, I quiet.
Help out. Just go to bed. You guys can do whatever you want.
Okay, I'm just trying to help out, you know? Oh, that was great.
Y'all, that is every single person who's ever been drunk, and they don't think they're loud. It's like,
Patrick. He says, I understand why she's frustrated, but tomorrow we're going to go to my dad's ranch, so that will make it better.
Oh, the most fucking codependent person in the world.
It's not going to make it better, y'all.
Y'all, that's the show. We've had such a good time tonight. Oh, we love coming to Dallas.
We love coming to Dallas. Y'all are really one of the best crowds we always have.
Yeah.
We love you very much. If y'all remember last time, we're going to line up for the VIPs. We'll line up on the side, and you'll just You'll be right there, and
it'll be like a big glory hole.
No, my mother's gonna be standing there. Anyway,
she can Google it.
Don't, Mama. Don't. All right. You know what Poodle did say for that baby outfit? He wanted to make tearaway jeans, and we tried to make some when we were in Austin. It failed completely. And then now he's come up with the idea, since my mom sews really, he wants my mother to make all of our gay outfits.
Because I want his mother to make my tearaway clothes. Yeah.
You're going to have to pay her.
What?
You'll have to pay her.
You're going to have to work for cheap.
You can pay her with yarn. The knitting sugars will love it. All right. Thank you, Dallas, for having us. We had
thank you, Dallas.
Thank you to the studio, the Factor, the studio. Thank you to everyone here.
Thank you to Frank. Thank you to Brennan. Thank you to Kelly. Thank you to Kelly.
I'm trying to remember everything.
Bailey.
Bailey. Braden.
And Matt.
Sorry, yeah. I was in a state when they saw me.
Someone got drunk off that one shot.
I think I did.
Thank you to our Sissy Squad and our Jackie and our mods. Thank you to Christina. Who's in the Sissy Squad here? Yay.
We have fun in there.
Our Sissy team, Christina, Caitlin, and Patrick. And as always, like, this show is dedicated to y'all.
You're shaking it off. That tequila hit.
These fuckers gave me two tequila shots, so. But seriously, like, and I mean this from my heart, not from my penis, which is usually what it feels the most. Our lives are changed, and thank you guys for that. And we could not do what we're doing if it wasn't for you. And we don't take that for granted.
Not at all.
So thank you so much. We're happy anytime we can help you feel happier or laugh at something when you're having a shitty part of your day, and that's everything we've ever wanted to do. So thank you for letting us do that. Thank you. I'm glad it helps you. It really makes us just ecstatic to be able to do that. So anyway, the other thing is, we know that nothing is the best right now. Like, look around the world, but things are going to change because they always do. And know that we encourage you to find your happy, have hope, and keep the fuck going.
Keep going, Queens.
Oh, Gary's right on those cues.
So long, sad times. Go long, bad times. We're free of you at last.
Are now a thing of the past.
We love you, Dallas.
Thank you, Dallas. Is that your brother, Swain?
Oh, yep, and get your troubles. Come on.
Happy days are here again.
We're gonna chase the all your cares
above
away.
The clear again.
Shout hallelujah.
So sing a song of cheer again.
We're headed for
happy
the judgment.
Happy days are here again.
The sun is shining.
All
come
together.
On, get happy.
Shout it now.
The Lord is waiting to take
your
hand.
There's no doubt about it now.
Shout hallelujah.
So
come on,
let's sing a song.
Happy. The river, soon your cares will all be gone.
There'll be no more from now on.
From now on, forget the troubles. Come on, get happy. We're gonna chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah.
So
studio in the back of the
See y'all after the show.
See y'all after the show. Thank you so much for coming. Drive safely.